Hey everyone, this is Ashish from Daisy Cycle. Today we are going to review this degreaser and lubricant combo from No Worries Bicycle. It's an enthusiast brand run by Anand Vanjpayee, who is an architect based in Pune, and he has been my Facebook friend for a long time. And I bought this from my own money, so this is not a paid review. I paid about 850 rupees for this combo. For 850 rupees you get a 400 ml degreaser and a 100 ml lubricant, which is sufficient and a lot more cheaper than brands like Loop Lube and Loop Vibe. So let's go ahead and get ready with the setup. I'll be just doing a basic cleanup of my drivetrain, which you see over here is not quite dirty, but it has a lot of gunk. So we'll be cleaning it up today and see how things goes. I don't have any equipment with me as well, so I'll just be using a toothbrush, because this is supposed to be a DIY video on how to keep your drivetrain clean. Okay, so let's go get ready with it. Okay, so we have waited for 10 minutes and you see that a lot of dirt has come out of the drivetrain without even doing anything, by just spraying the degreaser. So now what we'll do is we'll remove this remaining dirt using a couple of toothbrushes. Old toothbrushes, don't use your new toothbrush. And a mug full of water and some soap added to it. You can use any sort of soap, you can use a detergent, you can use a hand wash liquid, anything will work. It just has to be soapy, because soap increases the viscosity of the water. There's a lot of science to it, we won't get into it, we'll just start cleaning it. Okay, so we had a bit of an issue there, the bike went off balance. Now we have balanced it well and it should not go off balance again. So what we were going to do was, we were going to brush, dip these toothbrushes into the soapy water, and we were going to lock them on the chain, and we were going to reverse paddle. Don't make sure that the grip on the chain is not too tight, because if the grip is too tight, then you will notice, bike is going off balance again, then you'll notice that the chain is skipping, which should not happen. You see, I did the grip too tight and the chain started to skip. So don't make the grip too tight, just keep it gentle. If you don't have two toothbrushes, you can simply use a single toothbrush. All you need to do is just brush it like this. Using two toothbrushes, you'd be a bit faster. This will be a slower process, but this will be easier to. Just from single stroke, the chain is getting clean. You see the grime and dust that is over there, and if I just rub the soapy water over it, you see that it gets cleaner. And we do that with the entire chain in multiple cycles, so that we can clean this. Now that we have cleaned the chain well, what we are going to do is we are going to clean the drivetrain. So all these pockets that you see, just use some water, clean it well, remove all visible grime that you see. Also need to clean those small sprockets. You see, there's a lot of dirt stuck on them. You're seeing it, you see that as I'm cleaning it, I see a lot more dirt coming out, which is a good thing. Less dirt our bike has, the less grime it will have over the next cycle, and there will be a lot less grease build up. Clean all the edges we can reach. No matter what you do, do not pressure wash your bike, because there are a lot of components inside the hub. There's grease inside the hub, there's ball bearings inside the hub, which will have water inside them if you use pressure wash. So don't use pressure wash, because it will damage the components and it will start rusting them from inside. Just use gentle toothpaste, or if you can get access to a chain cleaning machine. I have one back in Delhi, which I use a lot. Here in my hometown, I don't have it, so I'm just using this Jugaad toothbrush method. So now you see our chain is a lot cleaner. There's not as gunk that was there on it now. There's no gunk at all. So we are going to do a little bit more brushing, and once we are satisfied that it is all okay, what we are going to do is we are going to let the water dry, and then rub it off with some clean cloth, and then apply the lubricant. So we'll just stop this now and wait for it to dry. Now if you see, most of the chain is pretty clean. There is no dirt particles. Even the drivetrain looks pretty clean. There are some things which we can clean up with a toothbrush again, they are just stuck and stubborn. We might have to do another round if it was not too bad, but for the sake of this video, I'm not going to do that. What I'm going to do is, since most of the water has dried away, I'm just going to remove it with a clean rag. So what I want to do is, I want to I believe we are mostly cleaned. You see the difference in the chain that was there, and now it's mostly clean, it's shiny, there's no dirt on it, so it is completely clean. Now we'll let it wait for a few minutes and then we'll do lubrication. So now the chain is completely clean, you see it's shiny, there's no dirt at all. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to use the Team Lube lubricant from No Worries Bicycles, and we are going to lubricate the chain. And what you want to do is, you want to lubricate each link a little bit. This, I'm not sure how I am going to do it with this, because this has a spray nozzle instead of a drop nozzle. The other lubricants that I use have a drop nozzle, so it is easier to lubricate with them. You just apply a pipe as we did with the degreaser, and then you add a drop to every chain link. But I'm not sure how we can do that with this, so let's go ahead and try. So what we want to do is, inside the every link that we have, we just want to add a single drop so that the chain is sufficiently lubricated from the point where it contacts the drivetrain. Lubricant is applied correctly. Now what you want to do is, you want to remove all extra gunk from the chain and only keep the lubricant. So anything that is on the sides, you just wipe it off gently. Don't apply any pressure, because we don't want to remove a lot of it. Gently wipe off all the extra lubricant that you have on the chain. Think of it like doing a massage, like a very soft massage. Remove all the extra part only. You need some lubricant to be there, so be careful with it. You want to remove the extra lubricant, because if there is extra lubricant on the chain, then it will attract more dirt, and next time the cleanup will be difficult to do. So slowly remove all the extra lubricant. And that is it. The chain is now clean and lubricated. It's so clean that instead of black, it's silver right now. And if I rub my hand and show it to you, you see that barely any lubricant is coming off. So it is well lubricated and it is well cleaned. Hey everyone, I'm not sure how you like the video. To let me know what you like about this video, share a comment, add a like to it, and subscribe to the channel. You can tell me all the other products that you want me to review or all the other DIY videos you want me to make. Now, to sum it up, as a review of this, the degreaser is very, very good. I'd recommend it. It cleans instantly and it is water soluble, so removing it is also very easy. Lubricant, I feel it will take me another round to review, but the applicator nozzle of it is either defective for me, or this is how it is with all. I'd recommend to have a nozzle that is like this, where I can attach a pipe and do drop control and apply lubricant only to the sections of the chain that I want to, instead of spraying the entire chain. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. So, seems to be a good product. The packaging of the lubricant can be improved. Apart from that, all is very, very good. I'd go for a demo ride and get back to you on how it went.